Well, the pictures of Kenny Dalglish celebrating just as Liverpool scored the winning goal against his club on Sunday will be long remembered. He just heard, of course, that Manchester United had failed to beat West Ham, thus giving Blackburn that title. Kenny's had a bit of time to reflect on his achievement now, and he's been talking with Gerald Sinstad.
I think there's still a little bit of disbelief about it, even now. But, I mean, the facts are there, and the first day he kept waiting for someone to pinch it to make sure that it was true. It was as if he deserved it, but it hadn't quite happened in the game. It still would be played, but we've 89 points is a marvellous tally, and it's if you get more than anyone else, you deserve to win it. And there's a lot of things that can be discussed and debated about the season, but the most important thing is that we've got points and we deserve the points. And if you get more than anyone else, then the title's yours. It's because Liverpool Football Club that I'm in the position that I'm in today. They signed me in 77 through Bob Paisley, and then in their wisdom, I don't know what virtues I had, but in their wisdom they asked me to become manager in 1985, and almost 10 years to the day that I was announced as manager, I come back and we won the title with Blackburn at Anfield. And if Blackburn Rovers were going to win the title and it was going to be anywhere other than Ewood Park, then I couldn't have picked a better place. Everyone's celebrating at the moment, and the things that were important to me about Blackburn Rovers was, unfortunately, was a man who made the first approach, who unfortunately isn't here at the moment, but someone that I had a lot of respect for was Bill Fox. His wife's joined in the celebrations and his family's been there, but unfortunately Bill died just shortly after I went to Ewood Park. But he was instrumental, really, obviously. He was the first point of contact, and I met Jack Walker. And it was impressive what Jack was saying. And it was truthful as well. His business was tremendously successful, which is brilliant for Blackburn Rovers, because he's been able to be the financial benefactor. And it's been even special for him because he's been a fan. And there's not many people who'll be fortunate enough to have Jack Walker behind them. The chairman is, and the board of directors do a magnificent job as well. On the footballing side, we've got Ray Harford and Tony Parks. I mean, Ray Harford's been there since I went, and Tony's been part and parcel of that as well. And from Ray Harford, I've learned an awful lot on the coaching side of things, which I don't profess to be a great coach, but I mean, I'm in there and in life to learn, and Ray's come in and he's taught me an awful lot on the coaching side of things. For Blackburn Rovers, the success is on the pitch, and that's where you get results. I mean, it's the first time I've been involved with a club that's only got one team in the town, or the city. And that's a wee bit special as well, when everybody in the town is pulling for the one club. Obviously, there was rivalry between Celtic and Rangers in Glasgow, and Liverpool and Everton. But here, they've got the town to themselves, so that's rewarding. And with the relative success that we've had so far, will come an even greater support. The first year we got promotion to the Premier League through Wembley, which really is some people's opinion that it's not the best way to have is to go through playoffs, but it's the most, I suppose romantic's the right word to say, way to do it. If someone says you're going to get promotion to the Premier League, where would you like to achieve it? You'd have picked Wembley. And we did it at Wembley. We got through, and as I said, the 3 years that we've been at Blackburn, we've increased our points tally, and we've increased the position or improved the position in the league every year. It's not about Kenny Dalglish, it's about an awful lot of people making an awful lot of very, very good contributions towards anything that I've done. And probably the greatest contribution has been the family that you have. I mean, three clubs have been very similar because they've been family orientated.